गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू सेंट जोसेफ्स इंग्लिश मीडियम स्कूल विजयपुर व्हाट्सएप डिजिटल लर्निंग क्लासेस ऑफ फोर्थ स्टैंडर्ड। आई एम योर मैथ्स टीचर। चिल्ड्रन, इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव कंप्लीटेड लेसन नंबर फिफ्थ एक्सरसाइज नंबर 5.6। देयर वी हैव लर्नड सब्ट्रैक्शन वर्ड प्रॉब्लम्स। That is, each problem are given in the statements. Those problems, by solving the statements, we have solved in our notebook. So today we are going to learn the new, totally new concept of subtractions lessons. New concept, the addition, combination of addition and subtraction. Exercise number 5.7. That is the last exercise of our lesson number 5. That is the combination of addition and subtraction. Means in the question both the we'll get, that is addition and subtraction. This question is in your page number, textbook page number 87, children. So let us see this question, how this type of question will be. First let us see how this kind of questions will be. Lesson number 5, exercise number 5.7, combination of addition and subtraction. I'll get the first example. See here, children, in one question only we are having addition also, subtraction also. So then one more question I'll take, that is here also bracket is also there. In that bracket we are having subtraction and afterwards we are having addition of this. Then how to find these kind of questions answer? Children, to solve these kind of questions, we use here Bodmer's rule. That is, Bodmer's rules means it is the easiest method to remember the order of the mathematical operation. Children, the Bodmer's rules is an easiest method to remember the order of the mathematical operations. That is the correct order in which we have to solve the maths problem. Bodmer stands for brackets, orders, divisions, multiplication, addition, subtraction. By using this rule we have to solve the above problem. But here we are having only addition and subtraction. So here first I'll take simple way to remember, that is B for bracket, O for order or of, D for division, M for multiplication, A for addition, S for subtraction. That is, we can remember with the symbols of that. Brackets means it's a round bracket, flower bracket, square bracket. All the three brackets in the Bodmer's rules we have to solve first. If you get a question which is consist of any kind of bracket, that we have to solve first. Then we have to follow the orders. That comes, it is in the further classes of your education, that is in the next classes. But order means, just I'll give you what is the simple mean. Square roots, to simplify the square roots is called order of power of. So next we have to divide. If the problem consists divide, then we have to divide first. Bracket, after completion of bracket, then we have to divide, then we have to complete multiplication of the numbers, then we have to do the additions, lastly we have to do the subtraction. This means, children, when we see the question, first we have to look. If there is a bracket, we have to first simplify the bracket. That means solve the bracket. Then afterwards, we have to do addition. Then we have to do the subtraction. Because for your syllabus, we are having only addition and subtraction. We don't have any here multiplication and division. So only what we are having? We are having addition and subtraction. So in the example A, children, we are having question 20,000 plus 30,000 minus 40,000. Means first we have to add the number. In that number we have to subtract the remaining numbers. In example number 2, children, first we have to simplify the bracket. In bracket whatever is there, maybe it's a subtraction. Because in the Bodmer's rules you can't say that it's a, you can say that subtraction is the last. But no. First bracket comes. So first we have to solve what is the problem given in the brackets. that we have to solve. Afterwards we have to do the remaining rules of the Bormas. So let us do the example by solving this method. I'll take this example again. 20,000 plus 30,000 minus 40,000. As per the Bormas rules, first what you have to do, children, we have to add the numbers. First what we have to do, number we have to add? We have to add 20,000 plus 30,000. When you add 20,000 plus 30,000, we get 50,000. In that 50,000, we have to minus 40,000. When we minus in the 50,000, if you minus 40,000, the answer will become 10,000. So answer of 20,000 plus 30,000 minus 40,000 is equal to 10,000. This is the meaning of this question. I'll take next example, children, which I showed in the earlier slide. Example number 2, 40,000 in bracket 40,020 minus 30,812 bracket close plus 25,452. This is the given question. So first what we have to do, simplify. We have to simplify the, or we have to find the answer in the brackets, which are given in the numbers in the bracket. What is given? We have to minus in 30,812 in 40,020. In 40,020, if you minus 30,812, the answer will become 9,208. To that 9,802, children, we have to add 25,452. Then you can observe, children, in the first question we have done subtraction last, but here we have done subtraction first. Why? The subtraction is given in the brackets. That's why first we have to simplify the bracket, then we have to do the addition. In the previous question, they are not given in the bracket. So first we have to follow the addition. Lastly we have to do the subtraction. Now add the numbers. 9,208 plus 25,452 is equal to 34,606. Children, what the small, in the small boxes, what I solved, same thing you have to do in your classwork also. You have to do that rough work in your classwork also. So answer of example number 2, open bracket, 40,020 minus 30,812, close the bracket, plus 25,452 is equal to 34,660. This is the answer, children. Let us do the exercise, the main exercise of 0.7, combination of addition and subtraction. Question is given, simplify. First question, 3000 plus 2000 minus 1000. Children, as per the Bormas rule, here there is no bracket given. Then what we have to do, children? Next step, we have to add the numbers. What, which number we have to add? 3000 plus 2000 is equal to 5000. In that 5000, we have to minus 1000. Like this, we have to write, children. First, we find the answer of addition, that is 3000 plus 2000 is equal to 5000 minus 1000. Now, what we have to do? Subtraction. In the 5000, if you minus 1000, the answer will become 4000. Therefore, answer of 3000 plus 2000 minus 1000 is equal to 4000. Got the idea, children? Let's do the B question. 4,500 plus 3,500 minus 5,500. So there is no bracket given. So what we will do, to children? First we have to do the addition. In addition, 4,500 plus 3,500 is equal to 8,000. In that 8,000, we have to minus 5,500. In 8,000, if you minus 5,500, the answer will become 2,500. Therefore, the answer is 4,500 plus 3,500 minus 5,500 is equal to 2,500. Let us do the C question, children. Next question. I hope you are understanding. In question, what we have to observe? If any bracket is given, because it is the only combination of addition and subtraction. Remaining things are not there. So only what we have to observe? If there is a bracket, we have to solve the bracket first. Then we have to do addition and subtraction. If there is a not given bracket, then we have to do addition, then minus, then subtraction. Let us do the subtraction. Oh, see here, children. In the C question, we are having the bracket. Bracket opens 7214 minus 2174. Close the bracket. Plus 6890. Let us do this question, children. In 7214, because we have to clear first what we have to clear. First, what we have to simplify. First, we have to simplify the bracket. So, first in the bracket we are having the minus. In 7214 we'll minus 2174. 4 minus 4 0. 11 minus 4 7 is 4. 1 minus 1 is 0. 7 minus 2 is 5. So for this 5040 we have to add 6890. So therefore, what we'll do? We'll find the sum of the addition of sum of the 5040 and 6890. So answer is 11930. 0 plus 0, 0. 4 plus 9 is 13. 1 plus 8 is 9. 5 plus 6 is 11. Like this, we have to find the answer, children. Therefore, answer of 7 bracket open 7214 minus 2174, close the bracket, plus 6890 is equal to 11930. Now let's take the D question, children. So in the D question, 27,000 minus open bracket 11,240 plus 10,370, close the bracket. Now in this question, what we have to do? First we have to simplify the bracket, children. That means we have to find the answers of given the numbers in the bracket. So in the bracket, 11,240 plus 10,370 is given. So therefore, answer is 0 plus 0, 0. 4 plus 7 is 11. 3 plus 3 plus 3 is 6. 1 plus 0 is 1. 2 plus 1 plus 1 is 2. So therefore, 27,000 minus 21,610. So we have to find the answer. In the 27,000, if you minus 21,610, 0 minus 0, 0. We don't have a number in the tens place. 10 minus 1 is 9. 9 minus 6 is 3. 6 minus 1 is 5. 2 minus 2 is 0. Therefore, answer is 5,390. So D answer is 27,000 minus 11,000 open bracket 11,240 plus 10,370 is equal to 5,390. This is the method we have to find the answer, children. Let us do the E question. 62,400 plus open bracket 70,800 minus 2,300. So first we have to simplify the bracket. In the 70,800, if you minus 2,300, children, the answer will be 68,500. To this answer, we have to add 62,400. Therefore, 62,400 plus 68,500 is equal to 130,900. Therefore, 62,400 plus open bracket 70,800 minus 2,300, close the bracket, is equal to 130,900. Let us do the F question, children. 20,000 plus open bracket 10,000 plus 30,000, close the bracket. Even though the question, all the question is given in the addition, we have to first simplify the bracket. In the bracket, what is there, children? We have to add 10,000 plus 30,000 is equal to 40,000. To this 40,000, we have to add 20,000. So answer will become 60,000. Therefore, answer of 20,000 plus open bracket 10,000 plus 30,000 close the bracket is equal to 60,000. Like this, each question we have to solve. On which rule, children? By keeping the rules of the border mass in our mind. First we have to clear the bracket, then we have to do the addition, then we have to do the subtraction. Because these questions are on addition and combination of addition and subtraction. I hope you understood, children. So, open the classwork, children. Write exercise number 5.7. Combination of addition and subtraction. Question simplify. By doing the example only, you start the doing, children. Along with the example, write the exercise question number 1 in your classwork, children. So write neatly lesson number 5, exercise number 5.7 in your classwork and homework notebook. Children, I am observing that many children are not writing, because earlier we used to get many photocopies. Now you are not writing, this means. So please do your work regularly. Complete it. After completion of your classwork, send the photocopy to my WhatsApp number. I hope this, children, you understood this exercise completely. Till you have any doubts, clarify with by calling me to my personal number. Today in this video, we have completed exercise number 5.7. With this exercise, because it's the last exercise of our lesson number 5, we have completed the lesson number 5. The next video will be lesson number 6. The next video, we are going to begin the next lesson of the our syllabus. That is, what? After the addition, multiplication, what comes? After addition and subtraction, the next will come multiplication. So next lesson is lesson number 6, multiplication. Yes or no? Yes. So till the next video, children, stay home, stay safe. Thank you for watching the video, children. Have a good day. See you.